We're going right across the country, city to city. We're looking for the next rapper, next R&B singer, next reggae sensation. Do you got what it takes?
Only one winner will be crowned at the grand finale is 2011 Canada's Urban Star. And this could be you.
You looking for a record deal, worldwide distribution, video shoots? Can you handle this game?
So don't wait, don't hesitate, and register today.
Welcome to Wired for Sound. I'm your host, Sarah MacArthur, and this is...
Jason Wellwood, CILU 102.7 FM.
Nice, he's got his radio voice on. Welcome to Wired for Sound. On the show today, we're going to be all about Urban Star. Urban Star, if you don't know what that is, it's a show similar to like American Idol and The X Factor and stuff like that. And you come out, you audition, but before the auditions that are happening the first weekend in June, there's going to be two launch parties. There's going to be an all-agers on the Friday night, and Saturday night is the...
19-plus.
19-plus show. So I recommend coming out to that, and also auditions. If you have some kind of talent at all whatsoever, singing, it doesn't matter. You can be a singer, a hip-hop person, whatever kind of music you like to sing, come out and audition. And that's on the Sunday, and it starts at 10 a.m., and it's going to be all right here at Jack's. And so first off, in the show, we're going to kick it off with Chris Sharp. He is the guy.
The guy.
The guy for Urban Star, Chris Sharp. So check out this interview with Chris.
Calling all singers, calling all rappers, this is your chance to show and prove your talents. Northern Remix Records and Funky Threads presents Urban Star Talent Search, hosted by Miss Melissa and judged by Juno Award-winning artists Belly and Chaclair, also judged by Bishop Brigante and Sadie. Winner gets a record deal, music video, and worldwide distribution. For more info, go to www.urbanstarcontest.com.
Pretty cool prizes if you think you have the stuff to be the next Urban Star. Here is your chance. We're going to tell you a little bit more with Chris Sharp of C Sharp Productions. How are you, Chris?
Doing good.
Nice so to tell see us that. About Urban Star. What is this whole contest?
Urban Star is a contest where if you're a singer, if you're a rapper, if you're a reggae artist, this is your chance to win a record deal with Fontana North and Urban Star itself. With it's a branch of Universal Music Canada. And the show is just basically... If you're an artist out there and you've been dying for that opportunity, this is your chance, pretty much.
Well, and it's funny because it's never really been done for, you know, this category of music. And you've sort of broadened it out a little bit as well. I mean, it really sort of goes to a lot of different genres. But it's amazing that, you know, this has never been accessible to people.
I know. And you know what the funny thing is? That market, that community is just dying for the chance to do this. So
yeah.
And what would it mean to get the deal that you guys are offering to a new artist, new band, whatever they may be? What does it mean to get all that opportunity?
It's everything. Because people out there are just, you know, in today's, you know, hard times, they're looking for that opportunity. So
yeah.
They're going to get a record deal. They're going to get a music video. They're going to get distribution across Canada, branding. A photo shoot is going to be
amazing.
Fantastic.
Well, and an opportunity. I mean, when you look at the people that you've got involved in this as well, on the judging level and everything, I mean, to get an opportunity to learn always struck me as being such a profound aspect of these shows. They get sort of underplayed sometimes, but the ability to go in there and people like Chaclair, who, you know, have such depth of knowledge about the industry as well, that's a really big opportunity.
Yeah, it's funny how the stars are going to select who is going to be the winner of the show.
Yeah.
So, you know, we're working with people like Sean Desmond, we're going to be working with Danny Fernandez as well, Bishop Brigante, Mishi Me, Socrates. It's going to be just phenomenal.
Not too shabby.
How excited are you for this, Chris? I mean, you had this idea how long ago? What, a couple
this
years?
This is 2 years in the making. And
wow.
It's been a long road.
Yeah.
It's been hard, but at the end of the day, you know, people have been asking me and talking about music for so long that, you know, it just needs to happen.
So let's go down to the nitty gritty. How do people enter? What do they need to send you? What info do you need?
They can go to the website. They can go to urbanstarcontest.com. On there, there's pretty simple instructions. They can either mail in or they can do an online pre-registration. And then we're also going to be going coast to coast, city to city, Vancouver, Calgary, Edmonton, Saskatoon, Winnipeg. Toronto as well, so live auditions.
Well, and places that in other shows, and I won't mention them, but they sort of skipped over big, huge swaths of the country, and you guys are being really aware of you know, the fact that there is this voice and these voices in every aspect of Canada that are really sort of bringing it in a really interesting way.
The beauty about Canada is it's so diverse, you know? It's got, you know, so many different races and so many different, I guess, layouts that...
Yeah.
The kind of talent in Canada is just incredible. And if you've noticed over the last I would say since 2010, they've been, you know, major industries have been cherry picking from Canada. If you, mm-hmm. the top pop singer was what, Justin Bieber.
Yeah.
The
yeah.
top rapper in the world is Drake.
Yeah.
The top
the stealing our talent.
Exactly. You know, even Michael Bublé. I mean, like, yeah. in every industry, we've been number one. Even in the world with Kanon, with doing the World Cup song. So if you think about it,
that's
all
so
the
true.
Talent is here in Canada.
So you're going to be doing live auditions. Who are these people going to be auditioning in front of? Celebrity judges?
That's right. There'll be celebrity judges, and there'll also be local celebrity judges as well. So nice. In each of the cities, we're going to invite industry people, singers, rappers, producers, to also be on the panel.
How cool has it been for you to see the submissions starting to come in and the quality that you're getting as well? Because I was talking to you a little bit about that before. How cool has that been to see people really getting onto this?
It's amazing. The passion that's coming from people, the way they do their write-ups for their bios, they have to send in their bios, their photos, and their music. And
yeah.
The quality is just fantastic. And it's funny, they're coming in from all areas of Canada.
Not That's
like
great.
It's amazing.
So once again, what genres are you looking for?
We're looking for hip hop.
Yeah.
R&B. We're looking for reggae. We're looking for pop, and we're also looking for soca. So it's a completion of the pop culture genre.
Yeah, man. I agree with that.
Very cool.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank
and of
you,
course
Chris.
We're
Definitely.
On board and we're going to help out in any way we can with
All right, there you are, my lady. One Jack's ginger ale on the house. Wait. Straw.
Awesome.
Welcome back to Jack's, everyone.
So Sarah, tell me, with this Urban Star, if you were to win, what would the outcome be?
The outcome? If you win Urban Star, you get your own music video, plus you get a major record deal, which is huge for any artist that's just starting out.
Hey, you know who actually signed a huge record deal last year is These Kids Wear Crowns.
These Kids Wear Crowns, yes they did actually. And they were actually in town a while back and we managed to catch up with them and they're super cool. They're from Chilliwack, BC and here's this interview with These Kids Wear Crowns.
Just sitting staring at the stereo. I think we better turn it.
Jumpstart, and you have your hit single, which, how much fun was making that video?
That was a great music video. Colin Minahan was a guy who we've seen his videos in the past, and I've talked to him about working on music videos in the past, but, you know, luckily it came together on this one because it just felt like this was the perfect song for him to work with us on and for us to have as our single, too. And the whole idea is definitely expressed in the video, I think, I feel that we're like showcased in it properly as well, like who we are really, really comes out. So we couldn't have asked for a better video for Jumpstart, I don't think. The whole idea was just great.
Awesome. There's a bunch of you guys in the band. Was it like six or something?
There's six of us. We're missing three. Just Alex, Matt, and Gypsy right now. But
yeah.
But like, how does that work? Like, 'cause there's six of you guys. You know, like a lot of bands have a hard time getting together with three guys. I swore I can beep that out.
Yeah.
See, we were like, the thing about our band is we were lucky enough to be best friends before we even joined a band together. So, you know, like lots of times a band's formed and you look for other people. Well, we did do that with one of our members, kind of.
Luckily he fits right in.
But he fit right in right away. But like the core of our band was all friends in high school and stuff, and then we decided, hey, we all like music, let's try this together. So it wasn't like forced together. Yeah. Like,
and me, Matt, and Alan, our old band, had played with Gypsy's band for about 3 years before we, or maybe three and a half or 4 years before we actually decided to form a new band.
We're like, hey, this guy fits right in with us.
Yeah.
Come hang out.
Name, like, do you ever find that, like, maybe you guys are going to be like 40 all together and calling yourselves These Kids? Have you ever thought about that?
We don't really like I mean, of course, that'd be fun. I think it'd be funny if anything. But we don't really look at kids being the standout point in the name.
Right.
Although I guess it kind of is. I don't know how.
Crown,
yeah. Well, it's just I don't really feel like kids. It's like teeny bop or like.
It's not really an age. You know,
yeah, that's
attached
that's what I feel.
To the name.
State of mind.
Yeah.
Know, everybody, if I'm 60 and people still think that there's a kiddish quality to me, then gay, hooray, yeah, exactly. That's great.
Great. You don't want that, really? You
yeah,
know?
Definitely.
Exactly.
Awesome. So how is it going for this? All the songs? Did you guys all co-write these songs on the album, or how'd that work?
Me and Alan typically, like, we'll get the foundation going. We'll write a good chunk of it, and it's easier that way when you have, you know, two main... And not to ever say that no one else can write, but it's just that's what me and Alan do, and we've been doing it forever, so it just comes natural. Yeah, and, like, the other boys definitely are... we all have our place in the band, so everyone's just as important as the next guy. But it has to start somewhere, right?
So. Yeah. And we all love, like, looking at the demos they do and kind of being like, dude, yeah. We really, really like this. This is really strong.
Yeah. You know, it's not like we write it and then show up and this is it, you know? Yeah.
Matt, play this. Gypsy, play this.
Like
it's very, like, we have a very good thing going as far as songwriting goes. And on Jumpstart, actually, we was the first time we co-wrote with people who weren't even part of our band, like big producers that we are big fans of, it was amazing. It was the great experience. Actually, like, I would say a couple of our strongest songs, including Jumpstart off the album, were done as a collaboration. So it was a nice, it's a nice new,
that's different.
New chapter
that's
for
new
us.
New for you guys too, right?
Like, yeah, we had never collaborated, not out of fear of it, but just out of, there was no reason to, number one, because we hadn't got to the point where we thought it was time to, bring more influence into the band because we were still discovering what our music was. But you know, once we started, we were about 8 songs deep into this album and we had to do another 4 or 5. We're, you know, you always drop
some
one or two.
Yeah.
Now, I hear a lot of people sometimes do like 30 songs. I just could not imagine doing that. But anyway, we were lucky to only have about 12, like I said, eight, and we were aiming for about 12 or 13. And so when we went down to record with Matt Squire, it was a few days in and he kind of felt us out and got a feel of who we were and we became closer and he showed us Jumpstart and he's like, I think this is something you guys can do. And we were like, that sounds exactly like us.
Yes, yeah.
You know, there was little things that we threw in. There was
gang vocals,
there was no guitars on it. And so that was a lot of fun too. And it was, like I said, it was weird because the song felt like we wrote the whole thing, even though we got there and it was pretty much, you know, complete. So
and I think that's why the producer, like, he thought it felt right because it was just like so us.
So you guys are from Chilliwack, BC?
Yes, born and raised, well, most of us.
Yeah. I'm from Vancouver, just about an hour and a half out, but you know.
He lives in Chilliwack.
I live in Chilliwack now, and I love it.
So you guys make your home there, and except for when you're touring on the road, of course?
Yeah, home is where the heart is, always, but most of our heart is in Chilliwack, always. We love to go back there because the only thing that changes is that there's new buildings built, and people are all the same. We love to go back to the same places we hang out. So
such a like large percentage of all of our families live in Chilliwack, too.
Yeah.
I have 17 first cousins and live on a dairy farm in Chilliwack.
Yeah.
And that's like, you know?
We can't leave now. We can't leave now. The mayor of Chilliwack just named a day after us.
Yeah. So seriously?
March 25th in Chilliwack is These Kids Workarounds Day. So
soon to be a national day, right?
These Kids Workarounds Day.
So
that's
we're gonna
awesome.
Have a good parade and stuff for the kids next year.
Why that day?
Do you want to tell the story? The surprise on Much Music?
Sure, you go for it, man.
Yeah, we were actually on Much Music a couple days ago, 2 days before the Junos on the 25th. And we had never even spoken to the mayor of Chilliwack before. Her name's Sharon Gates. And then Much Music, Skype, they're like, we have one of your biggest fans. Here's Sharon Gates. And we're all like, the mayor of Chilliwack? Is that? So then she Skyped us live on Much Music and deemed that day These Kids Are Crowns Day. She had big posters of us behind
That's
it in her
awesome.
Office. It was really cool.
Life-size.
And like I said, such a big percentage of our family are from Chillog, so it meant a lot. And next year we're going to try to like put together a good event for the kids and have something exciting come to our little town of Chillog.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Not too many bands can say that.
And you know, just going back to what we said about Neil Young, it's like this is the type of stuff that we love to do. We love to give back as much as we can. So, yeah. You know.
We just got the opportunity.
Yeah, starting young. Awesome. So, these kids wear crowns. Run out and get their album.
Can you feel the electricity in the air? Anytime, any place, it will always be there. When your heart stops, baby, heart stops, baby.
No fair use. He's cheating. Oh!
Yeah.
Damn him. Anyway, back to the show. Welcome back to Jax. We're hosting this edition of Wired for Sound, where Urban Star is going to be coming up the first weekend in June. But before we start talking about that some more, Tokyo Police Club, we're at Crocs recently, and we got a chance to speak to Graham from the band. And they're super nice guys. There's four of them. They're from Newmarket, Ontario, and they're touring their new album, Champ. And you at home, you're going to get a chance to win this beautiful album if you don't have it already. All you have to do is email us at cable10@shaw.ca and tell us what their first album was. But I never know when you're not. You never wear shoes without your socks. You never tell anything to me. I'm on your side, but only for a while, of course. You never use words you can't afford. A house with trodden. Well, what you're looking at right now is Tokyo Police Club, and they are unpacking their gear. And I'm here with Graham, and he's skipping out.
Well, it's a dirty job, but somebody has to do it.
Exactly. So they're touring their new album, Champ, and they're actually here in Thunder Bay for the second time. Sold out show last time. I'm sure it'll be sold out again this time.
Yeah, I hope so.
What is it about you guys that people just love? I mean, you're great, but there's something about you guys that people just gravitate towards.
I don't know. If we knew what made people like a band, more people would like us, I think. If we discovered that secret. Did you want me to say?
Tell us about the album. You're with Dino One Records.
True.
Tell us about that relationship that you have with them.
Well, our last record we sort of self-released in Canada, in a roundabout way, with distribution and all that fun stuff. And this time we wanted to do it more conventionally. That's a lot of work to do your own thing. We just don't have time for that. And you know, there's obviously it's not like the States. There's not a ton of Canadian labels, and Dino One just. You don't have to look far to see how successful Dino Alone artists are. And I mean, just talking to those guys, they really seem to get it. They just really have their heads screwed on right. They're really forward thinking. And they're awesome. I mean, I just hang out with those guys all the time anyway in Toronto. Nice. So I've crashed their office and they have an apartment upstairs.
You guys are creating a magazine.
Yeah. Well, it's just something that we're going on tour, playing this place so many times. And, you know, you have t-shirts and you have CDs and et cetera. But we wanted to have something different just to, you know, come back to some of these places. You know, it's our second time in Thunder Bay. We were playing a lot of places for the second time, and it's just nice to have something cool and different. And so we just came up with the idea of making this zine, you know, just writing a bunch of silly little things with recipes and pictures and, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
And it was just fun to get together and be creative that way. And it ended up the best part of it was just making it.
Really?
And yeah, it kind of started as kind of a scheme, but it usually these things start pure and turn into schemes, but this kind of started as a scheme and became pure. So
I
liked it.
Always with the girlfriends, always with the conversations, making up the lost time, making it with me.
Well, you guys are fairly young too. What's it like for you guys being on the road with all those temptations?
I don't know. We've never had a problem with anything, really. It's all we've ever done. You know, I don't know what it's like to not be on the road, because it's basically we went right out of high school and started touring. So to us, this is normal life.
Really? Well, thanks, Graham. Anything else that we can expect from you guys in the future? You got anything in the works?
Well, we're going to wrap up this tour, and then I think I have a solo record coming out in June, so I'll hopefully tour that a bit. And then in between all of that, we're going to try and get together and write some songs. But we're not really, you know, we don't have plans for like an album or anything. It's fun to write songs, and that's kind of what we do. So we're going
to
do that.
How'd you find time to write a solo album?
I don't know. we only practiced for a few hours a day. When we were writing Champ, we were all based in Toronto, and you know, I had an apartment there, as did everyone else. And so that was kind of how I relaxed. You know, we'd go in and we'd work all day writing songs, and that can be really stressful. And you know, there's certain parts of the writing process where you're just being very perfectionist and nitpicky, and it's horrible, honestly. That's not fun. It's necessary, and yeah. I think it makes better songs, but it blows. And so I'd go home at night, and to blow off steam, I'd just write a bunch of songs.
Wow, and is that something you always kind of wanted to do?
Something I always have done. I was doing my own thing before Tokyo Police Club. This was supposed to be a side project. It kind of ran away with itself, which is, I'm not complaining. So it's taking me a while to get something out, but here we go.
Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Trix.
And I'm Tracy.
And you're watching Urban Star
on Shaw TV. Star Tricks. Okay, talking about music, what kind of music do you like to listen to?
When I need to think and gather my thoughts, lots of Justin Bieber, because he's just knows how to tap into your soul.
How did you get into the whole comedy business to begin with?
Started out as a DJ, ended up as a radio personality, and then it just meshed into a comedy career.
Your take now on this whole contest. I mean, this is, I guess, a great opportunity for these artists now to stand up and make a show.
Well, what's cool about Urban Star is it doesn't just focus on one genre of music. I find that a lot of shows only focus on a certain genre, whereas Urban Star, we're going to hear reggae artists, we're going to hear hip-hop artists, R&B artists. So I'm kind of looking forward to seeing the diversity, but it's going to mean something to somebody. I think everybody that's a part of this show is going to take something from it, whether they win or lose. So I'm looking forward to the cool auditions.
Oh, Trix. It is going to be a fun ride, no doubt. Trix, on tour with Urban Star, so check it out.
Welcome back to Jax and Wired for Sound. This week we're trying something a little bit different. We're doing a picks section where I reach into my music library, pull out a couple of records that I'm listening to, and tell you a little bit about the music that I'm listening to. First up for you this week, we have The Creepshow and their brand new record, They All Fall Down. The Creepshow are a psychobilly band based out of the Toronto area. For those of you unfamiliar with psychobilly, it's a mixture of rockabilly and punk, usually with horror-themed lyrics. Creepshow are three albums in. They have a huge following in Germany, and this record is a definite progression. Maybe a little bit punkier than the last two records, but a definite progression for the band, full of catchy songs.
Can't fight.
Next up, we've got Anvil and Juggernaut of Justice. This is Anvil's 14th record and the result of the documentary that you may have seen that came out a couple of years ago. New producer and some tighter songwriting. This is probably the best album that the band has put out since the late 80s. And coincidentally, both bands coming to Thunder Bay. So not only should you be listening to these albums, you should go and check the bands out when they come here to play live.
Very nice. I'm so excited for Anvil. I can't wait for them to come here and do a little interview with Lips. Sticking with the Urban Star theme for our show, up next we go to Kenora for DC Productions. It's a small recording house in Kenora that if you're a musician, you can go and have your make an album there.
Hi, I'm David Casey. Welcome to DC Productions. DC Productions was founded last year, 2010, January 2010. What made me want to do DC was actually Deborah's idea, my partner. Just kind of started making it hard to go on the road with two kids. I can't keep breaking up with you. Deb had the idea, why don't you get a recording studio and, you know, and see what we can do. And I said, okay, and then we did. With technology today, everybody's got a studio at their house. That's why I decided to get something that was that much better, but at the same time, very affordable prices for people to come to record, so it doesn't cost them. I'm still paying for a record I did in Calgary 4 years ago.
He was able to put like music to my songs. It was awesome. Same time every day, all day, still stuck at a corner. Because I can't do that myself, so to be able to come in and listen to my songs and actually have, from just lyrics, been able to create music. Song that you hear always, don't know why. The whole CD be done and actually filling out all of the songs, it's really cool.
Having a good sound, you need good ears. Anybody can have, you know, amazing gear, but if you don't have good ears, you won't be able to make anything sound good.
Day and an hour ago.
Take a breath. Being on the road is great. You know, I still do it a little bit. Not as much as I did. First time I went on the road, I was 18. I came home when I was 23. Oh, it's not you, it's me. Don't you try to understand that you're... And we just traveled everywhere in the world and then, you know, promoted music, much music, videos. Tours opening up for all sorts of artists. It's a great way to get better at your craft. We got the home base business 2010 from the Kenora Chamber of Commerce. That was most definitely a surprise. It was pretty fantastic, quite an honor, you know, to be recognized by the Chamber of Commerce. And so then it makes us want to work even harder, and you know, it was a great honor.
We're going right across the country, city to city. We're looking for the next rapper, next R&B singer, next reggae sensation. Do you got what it takes?
Only one winner will be crowned at the grand finale is 2011 Canada's Urban Star. And this could be you.
You looking for a record deal, worldwide distribution, video shoots? Can you handle this game?
So don't wait, don't hesitate, and register today.
Hey, it's Matt Smallwood with Fontana North Distribution, and you're watching Urban Star on Shaw TV.
Hi, I'm Urban Star's Tracy Koga. We are in downtown Toronto, headquarters for Fontana North and Maple Music. And with us on a holiday, General Manager Matt Smallwood. First, thanks a lot for doing this interview.
My pleasure.
And thank you for Fontana North for coming on board with Urban Star.
Yeah, we're thrilled to be involved. It's a great project, so hopefully we can find our superstar that we're looking for.
Okay, so you're in the business always of looking for the next star. Let's talk about Fontana North, yeah. The philosophy and a little bit about this company.
Yeah, we're a national independent music distributor, partnered with Universal Music Canada. So we handle bands from around the world, labels. We're now kind of venturing into publishing businesses and other merchandise areas. We manage all genres of music. We've had particular success over the last few years in the urban genre, with our friends at CP Records, with Belly and Masari early on was really a big start to our business. And now with some of the new players out there with Jordan and Neverest, who are kind of a pop mixed kind of urban pop act as well. So yeah, it's still pretty exciting times right now in the business.
Matt, what was it about Urban Star that really caught your eye that you said, yeah, Fontana North wants to come on board?
Obviously, there's some key folks behind the scenes. There's a lot of passion for the project, which for me is anything in music that we're doing right now is paramount. It has to be passion first, and it's obviously we're working in some tough environments right now with music. But also just to do the outreach and find, you know, across Canada who's out there working hard, who's producing records, who's you know, the newest MCs are, new R&B kids that are coming up. So for me, that's just like the most exciting part of being involved with this, that we can go out there and hopefully tap into some new talent.
Okay, so when an artist comes in to meet you, Matt, what does he or she need to have with them that is going to give you the green light saying, okay, we want you?
One of our kind of philosophies around here that our president has kind of instilled in everyone is that the fans ultimately decide, you know, what's good. Because they react to the song on radio, they react to the video, and obviously they go out and hopefully buy tickets and buy t-shirts. Criteria-wise, you know, it's a lot of bands and artists are coming in here right now who are almost, you know, they're building their own business before they walk in the door looking for a distribution deal, looking for a record deal. So they're able to tour, they're able to produce records maybe in their basement or through some smaller kind of production houses. They have, you know, 4,000, 5,000, 10,000 Twitter followers, you know, X amount of friends on Facebook. Those are all, you know, those are all kind of the pointers for me that I'm looking for to see if this is something that we want to jump on.
How will a show like Urban Star change the map for urban music in our own country?
Hopefully we can find many acts through the television show. I'm sure there's guys in wherever, Chilliwack and all these other places in the West and in the East that are as talented. So we just want to give them a mechanism to be heard and to be seen.
Well, yeah. Thank you again, Matt.
Yeah, my pleasure.
I know, I think it's going to be a crazy ride. It's Fontana North. They will be the record distributor for the winner of Urban Star 2011. The search is on for Urban Star. I'm Tracy Koga. Eyes, finally reach for to make a switch from a frown to a smile. Now we got the speakers die, right? Pretending that a child like total beats like any part in Danny. Some more handy lambs. Why you getting drunk? You damn right. Slice and dice with Rambo, knife balls, feel like a cheese or white box of books, rapper like Trump. Got no money in our pockets, bring $1 million rhymes. And you know you're feeling our shit, you sing along with every line. Got you praying every night, wish your crew be as good as this. Ain't nobody putting it down like never mind, it's your big botch. Me, your top is seeing me. Round, clubbing every underground sound. You might get lost, but we'll be found. So no sleep, clearly be the best around. And if you want to put down, you better come prepared. This chick's slow, heavy, run, and scared. I'm gonna tell you once, not ever again. You wanna do get tracked, my rhymes are glad. Check 1, check 2, check 3, check 4. Dodge, rock, I beat score. Check 1, check 3, check 2, check 4. Sleep in a group, going through a word. Check 1, check 2, check 3, check 4. Dodge, rock, I beat score. Check 1, check 3, check 2, check 4. Sleep in a group, going through a word. It's the picture, hit you, get the picture. Bet your bitch will hit you when we spit the mixture. I'm big, never mind.
I'm Ayo.
I'm Miss Flo.
Baj Mahaj.
Right on. And they are playing at this year's Urban Star right here at Jack's. Now, guys, tell me, how pumped are you guys for this?
Always really excited. Might hopefully get a new crowd to come check us out rather than the usual local shows that we get. Hopefully bring out a different audience for this one since it's a bigger event day. So.
What did you get when you guys first found out that you're going to be performing for Urban Star? What was going through your head?
Oh, we were super excited. Like, we're always excited to play any shows, but when we found out that we were going to be playing for basically a whole new crowd, we were just pumped.
And the fact that it's urban is very, very influential for us with this show.
How long have you guys been together? How long have you guys been doing the rap thing?
Well, I've been doing this thing probably about 20 years. 13 years I've been recording, and I've been with Sleep Clinic for about 6 years now. So we got, over 200 tracks we've been doing, and just, you know, on the grind, working, keeping the music going, so.
Now what about when you guys play in town here, how do you pick your shows? Is it just, you just play whenever you can, or is it?
Pretty much play whenever we can. Whenever we're offered a show, we usually take it, unless we have conflicting issues with it, but most of the time we'll take anything. We'll perform anywhere.
Is it like, you guys are a foursome, shall we say, a quartet.
Yeah.
Do you guys perceive yourselves doing this for a long time now still, or what are your plans for the future with Sleep Clinic?
Just keep making good hip hop and having fun with it, getting stage time. That's all I can see.
Yep. That's why when we do our performances, we look at it like, this is our city, this is Thunder Bay, this is all of our city, all of us together. So when we got hip hop representing our Thunder Bay, we want it to come forceful. We want it good, we want it energetic, we want you out there feeling it, we want you happy. We don't want you up there watching us sleeping on stage in a sleeping bag, being all bored, you know, energetic, energy, people want to have fun, so.
My question is, why hip-hop, why rap, as opposed to, say, death metal or something like that?
Well, Baji was actually a singer for a metal group called Mourn back in the day before he was into hip-hop, but I've always just been a fan of hip-hop. And
not before I was into hip-hop.
I don't know how to play instruments, so rapping's a little bit easier than learning how to play instruments.
Well, yeah, Mourn, we like all sorts of music. Like, we do hip-hop, we rap, but we really like appreciate all the genres, and of course that is a part of hip-hop. It's all styles all in one. It's soul, it's R&B, it's whatever, it's rock and roll.
The three of us are also singers too. Like, I've been singing for years, like as long as I can remember. I've been singing since I could talk, and then I just started rapping with these guys like about 6 years ago, and I'll tell you right now, like, coming from a singer, it is so much harder to rap than it is to sing. Like, you can stretch out one word forever when you're singing, but when you're rapping, there's no way you're going to be able to do that.
Especially the fast stuff, eh?
Yeah, it's hard.
How did you guys all get together? How did you guys all meet and create Sleep Clinic?
Chad was doing his stuff with a couple other guys. Me and this guy were in an old group called League of Ignorance, and we all broke up, and Stefan moved out to BC, and I stayed home and wrote rhymes, and he moved back, asked me if he's still rapping, so we started rapping. Chad and a couple other guys, Royal T and Yes Man, Nevlev, right, that was that time?
Yep.
Yeah.
So they all ended up just,
open mics at, what was it, the office, eh? And Chad really liked what we had, so he invited us over to record our stuff, and he was groupless for a while and recording us, so we said, write some rhymes with us.
Yeah, it was Mr. Yo and myself, and then his partner left, and we were the two groups doing the open jams, trying to do hip hop. So he amalgamated with us, and the quartet just formed.
The fineness of Miss Flo into the group to.
So you're the last addition.
I'm the last addition.
Yeah. Shut up.
They were a threesome for about a year before I came around.
Okay. Well, yeah. You guys are really good. I was watching you perform, and it's good. to sing that fast, like,
it's hard.
I'd trip over.
It's hard, for sure.
So everybody, check out Sleep Clinic for Urban Star. They're going to be playing here at Jack's Friday, Saturday. I believe it's the 3rd and the 4th. 3rd and the 4th. There's going to be an all-ages show on the Friday and a 19-plus show on the Saturday. So I recommend checking them out. Listen
here. Produce the beats that'll move your head. Rhyme, you design like super fresh. The best MCs will let me see. Obvious, gotta be the MCC. Can't nobody put it down like we do. We put it down to make it sound so easy. The beat is dope, but the beat is dope. Gotta make the flow go breezy. Cheesy, for sure, I mean, for sure, for cheesy. Hope is dope, but the flow so freezy. Believe it, we keep it smooth.
Uh-huh.
Keeping the rhythm in the groove.
Yeah, yeah.
Y'all respect that, y'all, but a step back, sleep for the crew.
Thank you for watching this edition of Wired for Sound. We've been coming to you today from Jax, where Urban Star 2011 is going to be taking place right here in Thunder Bay. We're the first city to host Urban Star. They're going to go hit all major cities across Canada, and we are the first. So people, come on out, bring your headshots, your music, get in line early, 10 o'clock on Sunday, June the 5th, for your chance to get yourself a record deal. Don't forget, there's also the launch parties on the Friday and Saturday. Friday's all ages, Saturday is 19 plus.
And don't forget to tune in next time for more of my picks, because you never know what I'm gonna come up with.
It's true, you never know. So for Wired for Sound, I'm Sarah MacArthur.
And I'm Jason Wellwood.
See you next time.
Bye.
Bye. Ah!